Welcome back to Afternoon Express. Now, it is a Tuesday, so that does mean Masterclass is in session. And joining us is our guest chef of today, welcoming us back to the loft, Jay Duvall.
Our pomegranates are in season, and we're so cooking up a storm today. This is how you roll.
I mean, talk about a woman from Food Jam. She always keeps it jamming in the kitchen. Dumi, welcome back, honey. Lovely to have you.
Palace, I'm already there. Like, the moment Jade walked in, I knew that we're getting into the vibe today. We're dancing while we're cooking.
Absolutely, and it is all about the vibes. Well, class definitely is in session today as we show you so many fun ways to use those beautiful exotic fruits that really just don't get the attention that they should. So, Jade, what do you have in store for us?
I am so excited that we can chat this together. Shall we get started?
Awesome.
It's all about exotic fruits bringing out their flavor, their natural sweetness, and also because they're in season, we want to make them shine when it comes to this beautiful dish. Now, chaat is something fabulous that you'll see a lot on as a street food. So it's usually, I mean, traditionally you would see it with potato and a little bit of, you know, crispy onions and spices. Mm. But I know we're going to bring the magic. We're going to lift it up a little level. Okay. And we're going to make it with our winter fruits.
I'm very excited
about that.
Okay, so
let's get started with making a dressing. So dressing is punching flavor, but in a subtle way. Mm. And it's also our hero ingredient when it comes to olive oil. Olive pride olive oil is a great carrier for that extra special flavor with ginger, which also brings the warmth. Mm. And tell me, if you don't mind bringing us that sprinkle of nuts, a crispy element that is so significant when it comes to making chaat. Now, chaat is a snack. So if you plan on making it now, get started and cook with us. But if you want to save it for like a special dinner party as a palate cleanser, or maybe even, you know, start of a menu when you have a beautiful thali, a spread of Indian dishes together.
I love that. And this is exactly that. It's just something that is quite Eastern when it comes to its flavors and what we'd love to put together, Indian street food. But I've never tried it myself, so I'm very interested in how you're going to do this, especially with our exotic fruits.
So more points to the team if you dance while you're cooking as well. You know, that brings some extra special groove to it. So while you're peeling the ginger, beautifully with a teaspoon, I see your stars. You've done this before.
Girl, this is the quickest way for me. Yeah, this is the quickest way for me.
Grate it up for us and put it in a jar with about 60 ml of olive oil and then shake it up. Maybe some seasoning, some salt and pepper, maybe a bit of acidity as well. It could be lemon juice. It could be pomegranate juice if you wanted to go that route. Or it could be any types of vinegar. So you know you're building the layers. Fresh ginger, about a teaspoon, a quarter a cup of olive oil, olive fine and specific, and then also, of course, that extra special acidity.
Love that.
While you're going ahead, I'm going to make up our crispy element, which is our chickpeas, and it's a fab way of being able to make a snack. So you know how famous those baked chickpeas are, right? You know, as a snack, sometimes they're coated with chocolate as well, but they're even better when they're baked in the oven and they're part of a chaat. So I'm going to dry the chickpeas as much as possible. Tim, if you don't mind passing me a lovely baking paper, just so we can get all the juices out. Okay, they're drained, they're good to go.
One thing I love about this recipe is just the simplicity of it. You know, every time you come into the kitchen, there's always something that you bring, and the one thread that it is simplicity. You know, a lot of people like to overcomplicate recipes, and I always keep telling people, keep it simple, keep it easy. It's about flavors and not about, you know, winning awards. Yes, we would like to win awards, but let's just keep it fun, you know,
make
like
friends,
we do in the kitchen.
Right? Make friends and keep our family happy. So I like to season my baking tray in the beginning. That's where I know I'm going to get some flavor from the bottom and from the top. Mm. And I've got salt, olive oil, and a little bit of chaat masala. It can be garam masala. It can be whatever your magic spice is in there. Go for it. Chickpeas go in.
So I just want to show, I'm using my persimmons now. And as you guys already know, I was saying that the first time I got introduced to persimmon, or might I say Sharon fruit, because my mom calls it that, and that's the other name for it.
Yay.
It was very overripe and very soft, and you literally couldn't use it like this. But now you can eat it.
Right. So what does it taste like to you?
The first time it tasted like honey and mush and stuff that I really can't explain. But luckily this tastes amazing, and that's why it works perfectly in our salad.
Into the oven we go. We're going to bake for 30 minutes. It's going to be fab, fab, fab. And you know, as it happens here at Afternoon Express, we have magic baked crispy chickpeas.
Looking so good.
Fabulous.
So I'm almost done with my dressing, as I promised you, to shake, 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 shake it up. And it's just that easy. It's a homemade dressing. You know everything that's in here. You know that it's packed with that goodness. So you also know that it's pretty much good to go into this beautiful savory dish.
And also very seasonal, Balisa, because we're also using lemons in there. And it is that time of the year when we need to bulk up on that vitamin C. So it works perfectly.
Are you ready to pass me some dragon fruit so we can
please,
get cutting? Thank you so much. Persimmon's happening. We've got pomegranates going in. I'll show you a little trick on how to. pop those pomegranate seeds out in a little bit. Let's talk about pomegranates quickly, because I feel like this fruit has got so much to say. So pomegranates, they're beautiful, the rubies are inside, and of course, they've got so many antioxidants. Now, I'm not only talking antioxidants, I'm also saying that we have to bring pomegranates into any party. Put it in your drink. You know, have it as juice. How do you juice a pomegranate? And I would love to for you guys to share with us, what's the real deal? Like, how do you guys have your pomegranate?
And how do you best juice enjoy it? Yeah. So I'd love to find that out as well. And I can see you cutting into that dragon fruit. Now, for me, dragon fruit is one of those exotic fruits that just don't receive the shine that they deserve. Not only is it rich in antioxidants, it is a flavor carrier, I can almost say. I love that about it. And also with dragon fruit here, they say that it helps also reduce and lower your blood pressure. So I think that that's also very important for so many South Africans that might need something different, some new flavors, some new taste, but also they're still packed with that nutrients.
You can get so much from fruit. You can get all your medicines from food.
Honestly.
And can you see how I scooped it out? Like, I use that for an avo, I use it for a dragon fruit when it's get cut. And I also know that you've got some serious plating magic. So if you don't mind coming and joining us in a little bit to come and plate, that would be fabulous. Okay. The salad is all about layering it up. Okay. So chef, you're gonna work your magic.
Love that.
You're cutting all the elements together. This one is so nice and ripe and juicy because you can see that it's in season.
It really is in season. I'm gonna help you also just put this all up in there, Dumi. So is it okay if I just throw it in?
Yes, exactly. Look at those colors. I mean, you couldn't have a party on a plate that's better than that.
Delicious.
Are you ready to party?
I am. Now, we have shown you that fruits don't always have to be used in a dessert. This is some salad that everyone has to try. Now, to give it a try, please head over to our website, afternoonexpress.co.za, for the recipe and full ingredients list.
Yay, chefs! Woo! Rock and roll, ginger is in, and we're good to go.